listen to Ed Schultz.
Just banging away at these nut jobs across the street. Now, Beck has big ratings at 5 o'clock, but at 6 o'clock against me, they drop damn near through the floor. They lose half their audience. In the meantime, the Ed Show, right now, this month of August, we are beating CNN in the demographic 25-54 by 1.2 million people. In total viewers for the month of August, we are beating CNN by 3.77 million. We're starting to play in the arena of the big boys now. The other night, we got as close as we've ever gotten to beating Fox. Bret Baier beat me by 103 points in the demo. 103. Now, you have to understand that they have a big audience, but hell, they're all old.
I had to look up the numbers after he said all that stuff because it's insane. He's getting a point, the Ed Show, 0.5. It's a 0.6. You get fired at Fox with a 0.6. He has 117,000 viewers in the demo. His total viewership is 595,000. Bret Baier, who it does very well, but obviously I think it doesn't do as well as Glenn Beck. Bret Baier did 308,000 in the demo and a total of 1.7 million. So in fact, you could argue that there aren't a lot of young people watching at 6 o'clock in any case. The demo is 308,000 out of 1.7 million for Bret. The demo for Ed is 117,000 out of 600,000. It's about the same relationship. But this is he is totally obsessed. And one of his techniques to try to overcome Fox and beat Bret Baier, and Ed, I'm sorry, in your dreams, he's ahead of you by three laps. You're not even going to come close.
You have no idea in my bones, in my very soul, in my heart, I want to kick Fox's ass. I want to drive them into the ground. I want to spike the ball. I want to kick him in the teeth on the way back to the huddle. And then I want to turn around and lift my leg on him because that's all they're worth. They lie, they cheat, they steal, in my opinion. They steal the intellectual quality of the American people by constantly twisting what is the truth. Now, I'm asking you to be in this battle with me.
Uh-huh.
Because we can get Fox before the midterm. I know we can. I know we can.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So Ed's obsessed, but it's the same as Keith Olbermann's obsession. And they're both going to, and Rachel Maddow, and they're both going to be denied. They're going to live their lives in either second or third place. And it's going to be carved onto their tombstone. Second place, Rachel Maddow. Second place, Keith Olbermann. Third place, Ed Schultz. That's what's going to happen. So as they get more and more bitter, a decade or more of losing over there, they begin to, and believe me, I work there. I know how it feels inside there, losing. I lost too. They have to bring every narrative around to blaming Fox. You start with the conflation. You take one incident. You make it into the general thing. You make it racism, Islamophobia, homophobia, immigrant phobia, whatever. And then you turn around and blame Fox. Say it's the Fox News Channel. There's a reason this is happening. It's the Fox News Channel is the reason that Arizona passed that immigrant law. It's the Fox News Channel is the reason that 70% of the American public in multiple polls are against putting this mosque where they want to put it. Jeff in Louisville, Kentucky. You're back, Jeff?
Yeah, I'm back. I hope this is better. So, yeah, I think that Fox opinion, news, and radio and television intentionally makes people angry. And let's talk about this mosque thing for a second, okay?
Right. So
I think you all just lead the way.
None of these things would cause national controversy if Fox wasn't there telling people they should be mad about this.
I think that a majority of people who are mad about this are mad about it because you keep bringing it up. I think that ordinarily...
Really? President like did it.
First of all, the president did this, not me.
Okay, I'm not even going to get into that. Cause I don't,
well, I am.
I don't understand.
I was trying to talk about this before he opened his big mouth, and I couldn't get anybody interested.
So he didn't do it. You did. You were
no, he did it.
About, you were trying to talk about this before.
I didn't talk about it because Angry Rich, I'd bring it up and you'd say what?
Local issue.
Nobody cares. You won't get any phone calls.
And guess what?
As always, Angry Rich was right.
You tried to bring it up.
Yeah, so?
You brought it up and then you made it an issue that the president felt I needed to address.
The president made it an issue.
President didn't
Curtis,
make it an issue.
No, no. Okay. Jeff, the story had no traction before he opened his mouth about it.
Okay, wait. So wait, right there. It has traction.
Yep.
Okay, it's got traction.
Yes, it
you
does.
You all are using it as a means, and now it's got traction. But
are you stoned?
Before he helped you.
Are you obsessing about the word traction?
No. What I'm saying is that it was going nowhere.
Until the president opened his mouth about it.
Frankly,
you tried to take it somewhere. You tried.
No.
I did, yeah.
You needed the president to help you get it going.
Yeah,
and frankly, it might be in the end, he helped get it stopped. Yeah.
Yes, because once the avalanche has started, it's too late for the pebbles to vote. And what you tried to do...
A wrong is made right.
No, that's not... I don't even know if that's supposed to be a pun or what.
Jeff, do you get in bar arguments much?
No, I don't get in bar arguments.
You don't go in a bar and sit down and have a beer and argue with your friends about things?
Oh, no, I don't drink and argue.
You don't?
Okay.
I was going to recommend
don't get
you
married.
Don't.
It's probably this weed I'm smoking, man.
Hard enough time making a good point, you know, when I'm sober. You know,
yes,
making,
I noticed. Well, I was going to say, don't do this in bars. But anyway, Jeff, I appreciate you listening. I'm going to move on just because I'm running out of time. I actually liked your call.
Gibson, a brand of guitar, a potentially bigoted Australian actor.
I'm getting too old for this crap.
And a big mouth taco.
Put it bluntly, we need more babies.
That's John Gibson.
Procreation, not recreation.